Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we will see about Azure Custom Script Extension. So the Custom Script Extension downloads and runs script on Azure virtual machines. So we can use this extension for post-deployment configuration, software installation, or any other configuration or management task. So basically, the custom script extension agent runs the script to install the required applications. And the script can be stored in the Azure storage account or in the GitHub account as well. And also, we need to ensure the script doesn't require any user input. And also, don't put any reboot commands inside the script. And the maximum allowable time for the script to run is 90 minutes. So now let's create a storage account and upload some script for the IIS installation. And then we can deploy the Windows VM, use the custom script extension for the IIS installation. So let me go to the storage account. And let me create the storage account. So here I'm going to create the new resource group. Okay, it does exist. Okay, I can select the existing resource group and enter the storage account name. And select the region, and the performance tier will be standard, and redundancy I'll select the LRS, locally redundant storage. And I'll go with the default option and review. Okay, let's wait for the deployment to be completed. Okay, so the deployment is complete. Click on go to resource. So now I'm into the storage account which I have created. Go to the containers under data storage and click on plus container and enter the name here. So click on create. So I'm going to upload the script into this container. Okay, click on upload and browse for files. And I'm going to choose the install IIS for the Windows VM. And click on upload. Okay, you can click on this PS1 and go to the edit, and these are the two lines command for installing the IIS on this virtual machine. Okay, now let me go ahead and deploy the virtual machine, and in that we'll be using this script for the IIS installation. So let me go to the virtual machines and click on create. Select the subscription and resource group and enter the virtual machine name and select the region and availability option, no redundancy required, and select the image and select the size. Enter the username. Okay, so for inbound ports, select HTTP for web and click next. And here let's go with the HDD. And next, networking. So let's create the new VNet subnet. Click next, management. And go next, monitoring. Under the advanced, select the select an extension to install. So here you can search with custom script extension. Okay, click on next. So here we'll be browsing the required script for this purpose. Okay, click on browse, and here you can select the storage account. If you don't have one, you can create from here as well. So click on the storage account and go to the containers and select the script. Click on create. Okay, so we have selected the custom script extension for installing the IIS. And next, you can click on review create. Okay, let's click on create. Okay, so the deployment is in progress. Let's wait for some time. So it may take 4 to 5 minutes to complete this. And once this is completed, then we can check the IIS on the server. Okay, so now the deployment is complete. And here is the deployment details. Now let me take the public IP address. Click on go to resource. And take the public IP address of this virtual machine. Let me put it in the new tab. And now we can see that we are able to access the web server on this server. Okay, so we have installed the web server during the VM deployment itself using the custom script extension. Okay, so that's it in this video, and I'll see you in the next. Thank you.